Hi, I'm Nancy Skinner from FilmCreditsWork.com, and we need your help to help us tell some incredible stories. You all know Michigan was decimated by 10 years of recession, auto industry collapse. Well, back in 2008, in a bipartisan, almost unanimous vote, we introduced film incentive tax credits, and it was nothing short of miraculous. In just a few years, the film industry came. We told people, reinvent yourself, start a new business, go back and get a film degree, go back to school. You can do anything you want with this new industry. And guess what? They did, in droves. It was new hope for a decimated state. So at Film Credits Work, what we sought to do was collect those real stories from real people, not Hollywood celebrities, but people who have benefited, who have reinvented themselves and started making a living again, who can work and have hope that they don't have to leave Michigan. Young people in college don't have to leave Michigan. They can stay here and pursue their dreams. We've collected over 5,000 email stories, hundreds now of video stories, and we need your help to help us compile these stories, pick the best of the best, and get them out into the public with maximum impact, from social media research all the way through to an ad campaign. So what follows are just a glimpse of some of these stories from young and old alike, from mothers, film students, and small business owners who have found an economic salvation with the film industry. It's a great story to be told. This project speaks larger than just Michigan. It speaks about hope for all of our economic future. So I'm asking for your help to help us tell these real stories of real people here in Michigan who have reinvented themselves and found new hope in a new industry. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Amanda Toy, and I'm the Entertainment Group Sales Manager at the Westin Book Cadillac Detroit downtown. The hotel opened pretty much when the tax incentive started for film, and it's been completely mind-blowing how productive it's been in the hotel industry downtown Detroit. Personally, I was hired for the majority of my job to cover the film and entertainment market, and the hotel has booked over $1 million in film business alone, as far as overnight rooms, anywhere from crew to above the line.
I am Brittany. I am a recent graduate from Western Michigan University with a major in fashion design. I am currently working on the George Clooney movie, Ides of March, as a wardrobe assistant. I am sending resumes out to other states, but I would love to stay and work here in Michigan.
I am Fran, and my son is the assistant production coordinator of George Clooney's movie, The Ides of March, and I want him to stay in Michigan, and so does he. We need to keep the movies here.
I'm Kadeen Nicholson, and my daughter Lisa Wiegand is director of photography for Detroit 187. And I love having her here in town, and I want her to stay. I want the whole film industry to stay here in Michigan. It's wonderful to have them.
My youngest son Mark is living in downtown Detroit with a friend of his who is also a U of M graduate from the film program. They love living in downtown. They've rented a fabulous apartment. They eat at all the restaurants downtown. They go to all of the nightlife clubs. They participate in the businesses that are down there. They love it. Their biggest fear right now is that they're going to have to move because there will be no jobs for them very soon. In the past few days, I've talked to several people who I became familiar with during my boys' work in the movies, and talk to them about the $25 million cap on film incentives. And they live in Hollywood, and their take on that was, as far as Hollywood is concerned, with the $25 million cap, Michigan is dead to Hollywood. There will be no more movies here in Michigan.
So, Mom, what would it mean if your sons have to pick up a movie?
I would be heartbroken. I would be absolutely heartbroken. It never occurred to me that any of my children would be able to stay in Michigan. From the time we moved back here when they were in fourth and fifth and seventh grade, they all said, we're leaving as soon as we can. We don't want to be here. And two out of the three of my children have been able to stay. It would just break my heart to have kids have to leave again. I'm sorry.
Now, my daughter, Lisa Wiegand, had to leave about 17 years ago for Los Angeles because she was a Wayne State grad, wanted to work in the film industry, and there just wasn't anything here for her. So it was very hard to have her go. But And I got used to having her out there making the trip and just missing her and so on. But I was just totally shocked and amazed this year when she came back to be director of photography on Detroit 187. It was fantastic. I've been just thrilled, just floating on air ever since she's been here. But now she's going to be leaving again back to Los Angeles. And I'm just crossing all my fingers and toes, hoping that somehow the film incentives stay strong enough to keep shows like hers here.
Hi, my name is Dan McCarty, and Governor Snyder, you got 4 votes from my household. I reinvented myself and became a working actor, worked really hard taking classes. My business was failing, as a lot of businesses are in Michigan, as you may have heard. And at this point, I am just appalled that you would kill the incentives. I've seen firsthand what the incentives do. I don't care about the studies, even though they've been proving lately that they're working. I'm out there every day with many different demographics, and I see the benefits of the incentives have brought to Michigan on a daily basis. For example, I'm a dumpster junk removal company who provides labor. The dumpster companies that are my colleagues are renting out dumpsters left and right to productions. One of them in particular rented out dumpsters, containers, to 16 films in Michigan. I know his staff personally, and that saved their jobs. And they even got overtime, which is unheard of. So, you know, nobody has to tell me that these film incentives are benefiting Michigan. I know for a fact that they are.
Hi, I'm John Daniels. Yes, I'm Jeff Daniels' brother. But what I want to say is people know Jeff Daniels, they don't know me. But what I do is I run a lumber company, Chelsea Lumber Company. I'm one of the owners of Chelsea Lumber Company. And in the past 3-4 years, the lumber industry has been brutal, to say the least. So for me to be able to have new businesses, new people come in and spend money at our lumber company is huge. And that's exactly what the movie industry has done. They have come into the location in Saline, which is the store I run, and they have spent $300,000 in the past 3 years at just our Saline store. What that allows me to do as a boss, it allows me to keep people employed, keep people working almost 40 hours a week, not the 32, the 24. It allows me not to make concessions and more layoffs. So it's been huge, to say the least.
I'm Rose Gilpin, and this is my partner, Kathy Remske, and we are Real Style Extras Casting. We've worked on over 32 movies in Michigan since the incentives, including Detroit 187. We placed over 30,000 extras on sets. The common thread, you know, between those 30,000 people is they are all Michigan residents. In 3 short years, the film industry has become part of the fabric of the state of Michigan.
We've actually had extras who are out-of-work accountants become an extra, see that there is a payroll process, a business side of production, and we've known several people that ended up in the accounting offices at productions that we've worked on. It's a remarkable experience for Rose and I to place people on set as extras and go to interview for our next project and see our extras
in the office
working. And we just have to go out and find more extras. But it's actually a unique experience because people are able to actually observe the process while getting paid and fed, which is also a nice thing, and see how they can reinvent themselves. There are very few places where you can actually go observe the creative process and see how you might fit into that.
The film incentives work. The reason that I have a job, the reason that my employees have a job, is because of the film incentives. And even though those jobs are not in the film business, they are directly attributed to the fact that I am working in the film business. And so I'd just like to say that if you cut the film incentives and you make it so that we cannot make films here in the state of Michigan, you're hurting so many people down the line, so many lines of employment, so much ancillary income that comes in that's not figuring on any of your spreadsheets, Governor Snyder. So I'd just like to say to you in closing, cutting the film incentives hurts Michigan workers. And I am not going to recoup that business with a 6% flat tax on corporate business. Thank you. My name is John Manfredi. I'm a business owner in Michigan.
I am a graduate of the College for Creative Studies. I found my calling in film. I started my career here in Michigan. I belong in the film industry, and I am working in the film industry, and if the film incentive goes, so will I.
There has been some pullback. Saturday evening, a couple weeks ago, after there were discussions at the Capitol as far as a possible reduction in the incentive, I got a call from one of our major Marvel clients who picked up and left Saturday night, and unfortunately, we lost out on a $280,000 piece of business that was going to cross all of our summer months, which it would be a huge filler group for the hotel and really positive revenue for our rooms and food and beverage staff here at the hotel.
We've rented office space. We've made capital investment. We spent money. We built a database, all based on a promise of the incentives.
And we hope those promises stay in place for the years to come.
I'm Roland Nashif. I'm an independent filmmaker. In 2010, I produced a film titled Detroit Unleaded. It's a dramatic comedy about two Arab American cousins that own a gas station on Detroit's east side. And because of the Michigan tax incentives, I was able to stay here local. All my investors came from Michigan, and we employed over 180 people. And this year, it's slated to be released as one of the very first Arab American films.
I'm Ella Anderson, and I'm a SAG actor, and I want all the movies to stay in Michigan, because if we go, we'll be really sad.